Well, India's former central bank governor, Raghuram Rajan, says he's cautioned the government against a move that banned almost 90% of the country's currency. Now, in an interview with the BBC, Mr. Rajan said the short-term costs were significant, partly because new money was not printed in time to replace the cash taken out of the system. Samir Hashmi started by asking Mr. Rajan why he thought the move was a bad idea.
What we've seen is the short-term costs have materialized in one way or the other, that transactions, certainly in the informal sector, there's anecdotal evidence that they fell off considerably. And you can see it in the GDP numbers. Longer-term benefits are things like tax compliance. And we've seen some blip up in tax payments. It's hard to attribute that precisely to demonetization again. But the jury is still out. We have to wait and see if we see substantially enhanced tax compliance.
You had left office just before this decision was taken. But if you were still at the Reserve Bank of India and the government comes and tells you, you have advised us against it, but we have decided to go ahead with the decision, what would you have done?
Let me not offer a comment on that. I think different people have different answers.
But let me put it this way, that if the governor doesn't agree, and if you're talking about independence and autonomy, and if the governor doesn't agree with a particular decision of the government, in that sense, what?
If you vehemently disagree about something important, you have to make a decision whether you continue or not. Your ultimate ability to disagree is to leave the organization and not be part of it.
At one point, India was the fastest growing economy in the world, touching 7.9% growth, and then within a year it's fallen to 5.7%. Is it just demonetization, or are there other reasons also which are affecting the economy?
The problem of bad loans and bank balance sheets. That has been a festering problem. I think some of the effects of that you can see right from 2014. And we now have a bankruptcy code which was brought in, which gives us the ability to clean up hopefully faster. So some of these short-term effects, the demonetization, the GST, hopefully will be short-term blips to growth. Growth will pick up, but we need to resolve the twin balance sheet problem.
Do you think India still has the potential to grow at 8 to 10% or even 8% in the years to come, or are there challenges?
We need to continue the pace of reform. So if the intent of demonetization was also to shrink the informal economy, we have to make it much easier for people to enter the formal economy, right? To reduce the burden of regulation, to perhaps reduce the burden of taxation as you move. So can we make that transition easier so that we get sustained longer-term growth and we get the employment that we absolutely need? The world is doing pretty well once again, and that's less of a headwind, and we should participate in that growth.
And that was India's former central bank governor.